Nobody's Movie Review Podcast. I am Space Ghost.
I'm Funny Man Stan.
And we're here another week, another day.
This was a good week. This was a good week in movies.
We're leading up to Avengers.
Yeah.
I bought my ticket.
So did I. When are you seeing it?
I'm seeing it Friday.
I'm seeing it Saturday night. I gotta wait.
Yeah, I'm seeing it Friday. So Sunday we'll just come in.
Yeah.
And we'll do it. I'm
really excited.
I'm expecting a lot of people to come through. So
yeah. Yo,
watch this shit.
Before we get into anything else,
I got good seats.
Yeah?
You got good seats?
I'm
in the middle.
I got
5 tickets. I had to buy 5 tickets. I bought 5 tickets.
Did you have trouble?
No. No trouble really? At all. No.
What theater are
because
you seeing?
Because I'm in Yonkers.
Oh.
It was sold out. Like opening night. Like yeah, I tried to get the Thursday night, like 12 midnight thing. Yeah. Nah, not happening.
Did you?
But like,
is it AMC or like?
Another? It's a. Is it AMC? Yeah, it's an AMC.
I had to get a Regal.
Lean back, all that.
Yeah, I had to do Regal because I couldn't get AMC.
But that's like regular seats and shit.
No, they lean back because I'm in.
And I got 3D.
Oh, I don't need to see it in 3D.
I don't need to see it in 3D either. But it's in 3D. Fuck it. Fuck it. We got 3D.
I know they said. Whoever sees it in IMAX, they're going to play the first 5 minutes of Godzilla.
What?
Yeah.
Damn, we should go IMAX. But they don't have lean back seats in the IMAX shit. Yeah. Nah, I'm good on that. I'm getting lit. And there's a bar at this theater.
Oh, okay. So there's alcohol where I'm at, but I'm going to stay sober. Because if I start drinking, I'm going to have to pee and get up. I don't want to do that.
I'm not going
to
pee. I'll pee right there.
So
I'll pee in the cup.
I'm in the fourth row, but they're... They're fully reclined seats.
Yeah, I mean, so, we in the middle, bro.
That's dope.
Middle, 5 people. Oh, all the people in the middle. 5.
So it's me and my 2 cousins, right? We just went to see Shazam.
You saw it?
Yeah.
Oh,
did you see it?
I'll see it just to review it with us next week.
Shazam's good.
I'll see it to review it. I'll go see it to review it with you. So I'll see it this weekend.
So
I'll see it this week.
We're in the same, like, so the tickets we got literally for Shazam are the exact same seats. Exact same theater for Avengers.
What?
Yeah. Like, I was sitting there, I was like, this is familiar.
I think I got the same seats
that you got for Avengers last time?
Captain Marvel.
Oh, okay.
The same seats. I don't know if it's the same theater. I don't know if they switched the theater. Yeah. I don't know if it's the same movie theater.
Yeah.
But I don't know if they switched the theater.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
But it's the same seats.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
Dude, I'm excited for Avengers, man. What do we got? 2 weeks?
I can't wait, bro.
Like those,
that I haven't seen any trailers.
That three.
I told you when us. I covered my head like covered my head like this. Like,
yeah. So you heard it though.
Dead ass. I heard it. I definitely heard it.
I don't think anything.
I heard the trailer.
I don't think it said anything. It didn't tell me anything. Yeah.
I just heard crashing and moving.
It was the whatever it takes one. When they were like, or whatever it takes.
Yeah. It says whatever it takes, but then it's like I just hear crashing.
Right.
And this and that. So I didn't see anything.
Yeah.
The only thing I saw in the beginning of the trailer was the old like Iron Man in the sand, like
but
back
that's,
in
that's
Iron
old
Man
footage.
One.
That's Iron Man 1. Yeah.
That's the only thing I saw. Yeah. Other than, then I covered my face.
Yeah.
After that, so yeah. I don't know what happens after that. I don't know what.
So like when you go to the movies, do you not go in until the movie actually starts to avoid trailers?
No. I'd rather watch a movie, but that trailer specifically, I'm avoiding.
Yeah, okay.
Like, Avengers, I'm avoiding specifically. Okay. But I've seen trailers. Like, I see trailers.
Like, on That's My Shit podcast, we were talking about, and, like, this is, they get into the, especially, like, some of my other friends that are, like, really into it.
Yeah.
Like, I'm into it, but, like, I don't like the breakdown of the trailer. Like, they do that all the time.
Yeah,
they were
don't
like,
do it.
Somebody was like, yeah, what about this and that? And I was like, I didn't even notice that because I just watched the trailer because it's, like, whatever, but... I don't delve into it because
I don't watch the trailer. I don't want to watch the trailer.
Yeah, because
especially
like,
for a movie like that, I don't want to see. Because
you said it before. It's like you expect something, and then you kind of changes your excuse.
Not even that. It's just like some trailers tell you the whole movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Some trailers tell you the whole fucking movie.
Like, and this is I don't know why Marvel decided to do this. I don't. They just announced that that. The next Spider-Man is going to be the last one for the MCU because Sony wants the rights back or whatever. But
they're going to give him the rights back?
I think so. Something like that.
I don't think so, bro. Because they
have
the Fantastic Four also.
Yeah. And I don't know how true it is. It was like a rumor that I heard. But I thought it was kind of funny that they put out the trailer
Far From Home shit.
So it kind of ruined. Like,
but I still didn't. I didn't see that trailer either.
You didn't see it?
No, I won't. I won't see that. I like Spider-Man.
Yeah.
I'm not watching that trailer.
Yeah. I think
if I really like a movie franchise or something, I'm not gonna watch a trailer. Like, nah. Like Game of Thrones, still haven't seen the trailer for it.
Really?
Yes. Okay. Things like that. Like, things that are big like that, I avoid.
And again, it's one of those things.
I avoid.
A bunch of my friends are sitting here, you know,
the only trailer I saw for Game of Thrones was the first teaser one. Yeah. Like a teaser I watch. Yeah, yeah. Like a teaser, like just show the people, and then like that's the only thing I watch. Other than that, a full length trailer, I don't know.
I haven't seen the last one, and I don't. There's no point in watching. It comes on next week. Why would I?
I haven't watched anything. They announce trailers now, and I'm like, why are you announcing a trailer to a movie? Like people just want to see the movie, bro.
Yeah.
Stop doing that.
And like they put out a bunch of trailers at CinemaCon this week.
I don't give a fuck about trailers.
CinemaCon, they put out. They mentioned a bunch of other stuff. I really wasn't paying too much attention, but
I don't care. Whatever.
But yeah, so this week, like I said, definitely check out Shazam.
I'm gonna review it next week. We'll review Shazam. I'm definitely gonna watch it. Because I didn't think you were gonna go see that, and then you went to go see it.
It was like out of nowhere. My cousin.
It's
like,
a Marvel movie.
DC.
It's a DC movie.
Yeah.
Oh God.
Yo, honestly.
Oh my God.
Top two DC movies.
All right, let's see.
Top two.
Better than Dark Knight?
Yes.
Better than Dark Knight?
Well, no. I'm DCEU, I should say. It's better than any of the DCEU movies.
What the fuck is EU?
Like, so.
I'm so.
Dark Knight Rises and all that, those don't count. The Christian Bale ones?
The Christian Bale movies don't count?
Don't count for the DCEU.
Only up to Ben Affleck?
Yeah, that's where it kind of started.
DC's
fucking up because the kid that played Flash already dropped out. He's like, I'm out.
Because he sucks.
He wasn't that bad.
Flash sucks, bro. And he's a series.
I do like the actor.
And he's a series. And he didn't have his own movie. I would have dropped out too.
Yeah. I don't know. I thought the actor that plays him on the show was fine. Yeah. I don't know why they didn't. I don't know. DC is all over the place. They haven't.
Because they suck.
The shitty part is they have good, compelling characters. They have the best villains. DC has the best villains, hands down.
Joker is the best character in DC.
Yeah.
Joker is the best. And I haven't seen a trailer for that either.
Oh, that one? Yeah. That one doesn't count either. That's another separate. It's a separate movie.
See, but why are they doing that?
I don't know. I think because Jared Leto is already.
That's why I said Deadpool is a part of the next Avengers, because there's no way, like, everything in the Marvel universe connects.
I mean, right.
Everything from the X-Men to everybody.
Right. DC is all over the place.
See the poster the other day, X-Men versus Avengers. I'm pretty sure that's the next phase that they're gonna go into.
Where'd you see that?
Not like a real thing. Like it was like a comic book, like an old comic book.
Scared me.
It was like an old comic book.
What?
It was like an old comic book. Poster.
Oh, okay.
From like the 60s, I'm wondering, 80s or some shit like that.
See, this is why, like, I start thinking about stuff like that. I'm like, all right, I don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but like,
I'm down for the next phase. I'm down for that.
Yeah.
Phoenix, and then after Phoenix, you do Avengers versus X-Men.
That'd be fire. That'd be dope, yeah.
That'd be fire. The movie would cost a fucking shitload of money.
Make it like,
but they're probably
going
to make it in this movie right here.
You think they introduce
They'll
them?
Make enough to
I
do
think they have to introduce. Them and or Fantastic Four.
Fantastic Four for sure. I think
have to.
I'm not gonna speculate. So, but
son,
it's something with the Silver Surfer and Thanos. Like, that's what I heard. But
or like Galactus, like they probably introduced Galactus.
I think it's something with Silver Surfer and Thanos in the comics. Something happened there. So I think like,
well, they
I'm
both
not gonna
they
go
both
out
worked,
my way, but that's
they
how
both worked for Galactus at one point. So
I
maybe guess, that's what they
don't know. Who knows?
Like. If they do that, it's gonna be a standing ovation. I'm gonna get up and start clapping if they introduce Fantastic Four. I love the Fantastic Four. I've always.
They're cool.
X-Men too. Like I've always been.
X-Men big. Fire. I've always if they do X-Men versus Avengers.
That'd be great.
Movies blown up. Like, they're automatically selling everything.
Yeah.
Well, they already are, but to another extreme.
They said it broke records. It broke pre-sale records. Avengers.
Yeah, my bad bet. Because everybody fucking tweeted about it. I was tight when people tweeted about it. I was like, why the fuck y'all tweeting this? Just buy your fucking ticket.
Shut the fuck up.
Don't let everybody buy the shit.
Like they said, this is what I found weird. It's like, when you buy tickets, you buy them through Fandango or do you? Like,
This time I bought it through Fandango.
I typically do.
I'm about to get the movie shit though. I'm about to get that.
What movie shit?
The pass shit?
Movie pass is not. It's not worth it.
The Stars pass? Where you get three movies a month?
Yeah, it's not. They changed that because they were losing money.
Wow.
Because it was like you pay monthly, and you just go whenever,
it's
right?
Like $30 a month.
Yeah, but they were losing money because people would like they.
No, you pay monthly, you get 3 free movies in that month.
I thought it was unlimited.
No, you just get 3 free movies in that month.
Look into that because I thought about doing it too.
You get short lines. You get to go through the little fast line shit.
Yeah,
and then you get the
Which you got theaters? Any theater?
The AMC shit.
Okay. But not that separate movie pass thing, right?
I don't know what that is.
Because there was something I heard about. It was like around last year. They were like, movie pass, you pay a certain amount of money.
No, I know AMC has like a Stars pass. You get like 3 movies a month.
Yeah.
Something like that. You get 3 free movies a month. And then you get like perks, like you get past the line. And sometimes they give you like
I just signed up for Regal Club
or some shit like that.
I don't know. You get points. I just signed up for that just because.
I have every fucking movie point thing.
Yeah.
But all right. I think I'm gonna sign up for that Star Pass shit too.
Let me know how it is.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to Avengers. I'm gonna see it.
What order do you want to go in with these movies?
What Shazam? Huh? What order? Are we gonna do? You want to talk about this Kevin Hart shit? We just talked about Avengers for 10 minutes.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
You want to talk about this Kevin Hart shit for a little bit?
Yeah. I liked it. Yeah, I watched it last night.
You did?
Yeah. I thought it was alright. I mean.
I liked it a lot.
The bit that he does about the gun compartment when he's
it's a little much.
It is, but like you know what got me? The fact that he's laughing. Through it.
It didn't get me.
No?
No.
I like him laughing through it. That was
the worst joke out of all of them to me. I like the shit about his kids. Shit like that, I like. I like that shit because I'm around kids sometimes, so I see how the kids act.
Yeah,
and I think that shit is funny.
When he's talking about how his daughter bullies his son.
Now the funny shit is the phone shit.
Which phone shit?
He said I took my son's phone. He automatically turned into a crackhead. Like that shit had me rolling. It's like take my leg. Like shit like that is funny to me.
He's like, why you gotta do me like that, daddy?
He's like, what's the password? Fuck you. What? Shit like that is funny, son. That's the password.
That was good. He's like, scratch your neck. I'm sorry, but I apologize about that.
See, that shit is funny.
How old are his kids?
The compartment shit wasn't even that funny.
I thought it was hilarious.
His kids are older now. I think his kids is like 14, 15 probably.
Like sometimes I'll talk about his kids and I'm like, are they still
got a kid, though.
He just had a baby, right?
He just had a baby, yeah.
When he's talking about his friend's baby, the great baby,
yeah,
he just slid the pamper over and shit. The dog,
Kevin Hart
shit. He's like, I mean, people shit on him.
A lot of people don't like him, bro.
My theory,
he was just on Joe Rogan too yesterday.
So I was listening to a little bit of it. I didn't listen to the whole thing yet. First off, did you listen to it?
I listened to the whole
thing. He says Popeye's very weird. Why does he say Popeye's like that? Is that a Philly thing?
He's from Philly.
Is that how they say it? They shouldn't say it like that. That's not how it's said. Popeyes. I was like, why are you saying it like that? You kept saying
Popeyes.
Popeyes. I was like, stop. Popeyes. Stop. It's like, if I ever go to Philadelphia and they start saying it like that, I'm like, nah, you guys, it's Popeyes. I don't know why you guys.
They said they had Patrice stories.
Yeah, I got to listen to the whole thing. I love Patrice, man.
Kevin Hart's Patrice stories are funny.
Yeah?
Yo, he said one time he was on stage, he threw a phone book at him. Yo, that shit. He said he threw a phone book at him. He said, read that. It's better than the material you're fucking doing. Yo, that shit was funny, man.
I guarantee you right now, there's a lot of comedians in New York. I'll tell you a quick story about the other day. But if Patrice was still alive, a lot of people wouldn't be doing stand-up. A lot of people would have quit because Patrice would have fucking bullied them out of it.
But that's what Kevin was talking about. Because he came up when Patrice was up there. So he was coming up.
Patrice came from Boston. He came from Philly. And they kind of came to New York around the same time. Maybe Patrice a little sooner.
Nah, he said it was him. He named everybody he was with. But
Bill Burr? Did you say Bill Burr?
Yeah, like Bill Burr. Him, Bill Burr, a lot of people. He named all the people he was with.
I remember.
He was talking about Bill Burr getting mad at Patrice. Like, shit's not funny.
I like Joe Rogan. Sometimes it's like, depending on who the guest is, I'll listen. Sometimes it's like somebody I don't really know or care about. I won't. But a lot of times, especially if it's a comedian, I'll definitely listen. He had on Luis J. Gomez, who I'm cool. I know.
Yeah.
I don't think he knows me, but he doesn't remember me. But back when I was producing shows, he used to swing by Eastville and perform or whatever. Like that was a great listen. Because you can tell when it's different. It's different when it's someone that Joe knows
the shit with Schultz.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Yeah,
he like Joe Rogan likes people who
Think differently.
Do things differently. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I ever tell
then
you,
he'll switch his shit up.
Yeah, I ever tell you, Schultz helped me dig out my car in the
yeah,
snow.
Yeah, yeah, you told me that one.
It was good. It was a good time. He's a good guy. No, but there's too many comedians in New York, and I feel like if Patrice was still alive, a lot of people would have just quit.
You think there's too many comedians in
yes.
New York?
Yes. Like, yes.
Overabundance.
Too many.
The niggas ain't that good though.
I know. That's the problem. There's too many that aren't good.
A lot of people working their shit out, bro.
Sure, sure. Maybe some of them should stop. I don't know.
I don't know.
Like, all right, the other day, Comic Strip Live on 82nd and 2nd, right?
Yeah.
Every year they do like a lottery, right? You show up, they give you a ticket, and the number on the ticket, they give you
The open mics will be packed, and everybody's chilling.
The open mics are packed. yeah. Why do you think I have to come to fucking Delancey to sign up for open mic at 4 o'clock? When the shit don't start till 10.
Oh my God. Like, that sounds crazy.
Son, it's bananas. Like tomorrow, same open mic, same spot.
But is it? Are you seeing the same people every week?
Mostly, yeah, usually. Like the same. There are people that go to the same open mics every day. Every week. It's the same people. And then sometimes people will go to different. Like the people I know that are, to me, the people that
really want to be comedians.
Yeah. Man. The people that I fuck comedian with really gate. Are the people that I see at different open mics.
Shit is comedian gate.
Honestly, it's too many.
You was doing that shit before. There all this shit though.
I've been
podcast blew up and then comedy blew
yeah.
up.
Yeah, like because everybody, it's like it's just people. Every comedian, every comedian has a podcast. Any comedian that tells you that don't have a podcast, they're not.
Yeah,
I don't know,
but I don't. See, this is why like Ebok.
Yeah. Ebok. Who, by the way, I ran into at the open mic.
Oh, okay.
Last week.
Yeah, but Ebok. He does comedy and shit, but he wanted us to be like a broader podcast. He's like, oh, we don't have to talk about movies and da da da. But I'm like, nah, because there's no lane.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody's doing comedy and nobody's doing this and doing that.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I want to do a movie podcast because if we do strictly movies, it's strictly
right.
movies.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It does, it's a niche. But it's a lane.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, we can have actors on here talking about their shit.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we can have different things like that. So it's just a lane
right.
instead of having a fucking open world sometimes.
Because a lot of people do that.
I feel like everybody has an open world. Everybody's talking about this. Everybody's talking about this.
Everybody's talking about the same things. Like,
yeah,
you ever listen to
Even Joe Budden's podcast, he's talking about us.
Yeah.
Even Charlamagne and Andrew Schultz shit, they're talking about us.
Yeah.
They're talking about Avengers.
Yeah.
But we are like, you gotta come to us
right.
for the Avengers
yeah.
talk. Like,
yeah.
we're gonna go deep.
They're gonna talk about other shit.
We're just talking about that shit. Like, you wanna just talk about movies? We here to just talk about
right.
movies. And we have a guest next week, another who kinda wants to be a co-host, but
okay.
we'll see. All
right.
And I'm gonna throw a curveball as a black girl, so.
Oh. All right. She cute?
Yeah, she's all right.
All right, see? Now. So the other day, the Comic Strip Live was giving out these tickets, right? You show up, you get a ticket,
yeah.
The number on the ticket, they call your number out, you go up, and they give you a date in the future to come back to audition.
Yeah.
Right? They said be there at 5, I showed up at a little before 5, the line was like down the block and around the fucking corner, bro. There was like 300 comedians there.
That shit don't make no
Yo,
sense.
Yo, it was, people I've never seen before, like, I would say out of the 300 people that I saw there, I might have seen 50 of them,
but do you
and
think,
I know maybe 30.
Do you
30.
Think this comedy thing is going to last? Like, Kevin Hart was going through how he does sets. Like, he went through he broke down his process.
Mm-hmm. I heard he said he goes to, I didn't listen to it, but
he said he does
clubs first.
He does comedy clubs first.
And then he goes to stadiums?
He'll do like a little, you know, he'll do like bigger stages and
yeah.
shit, and then he'll do like one arena.
Mm-hmm.
And see how if he doesn't like the way it sounds in
that one. He's talking about the sound, right?
Yeah, if he doesn't like the way it sounds, like no, like laughs wise.
Yeah, yeah.
If he doesn't like the way it comes off in the arena one time, he'll go back and do clubs and
okay.
shit like that until it sounds right in an arena.
I think in terms of what though, do you think was what gonna last?
Like all these people trying to do comedy.
Yeah.
You know what? I give it 2 more years, bro.
I hope. I hope.
Listen,
they all quit.
Like this podcast right now. Podcast is in like a big ass
yeah.
thing. You know what I'm saying? And some are big, some are small, some are doing this, some are doing that. Even us, like we big, we get numbers. Sometimes we mm-hmm. don't. So it's like this is big podcast bubble kind of thing.
It's got to burst.
It's not. It's not gonna burst the way people want it to burst.
Okay.
People think, oh yeah, all this, my podcast is gonna be popping, da da da. It's just because white people are not on to the next shit yet. They didn't find the next thing that black people were doing yet.
Like, I honestly, I wish I had started way sooner. Like, people, like, Bill Simmons was doing his podcast, started, like, bro, way back
you
in
know
day.
Me, like, I was there in the fucking mud.
Yeah.
Everybody's like, what the fuck is a podcast?
Yeah.
Why you don't put your shit on fucking satellite radio?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know, I was like, yo, podcast, where's that? I'm telling
you. Dude, before I was doing That's My Shit, I remember I did Joking Off? I don't know if you remember.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was like right then, and I jumped.
Yeah, that
in.
Was after me.
Yeah,
that was after me. He was like, "Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that shit this way," and I showed you how to put on iTunes and shit.
Right, and then I was advised. I'm not gonna say who advised me to do this, but I was advised not to put it on iTunes, to put it on, because I was writing.
Nah, fuck that.
Yeah, that's one of my biggest regrets.
That's why I said fuck that. Even when we were doing the formalities, and nobody was doing the shit.
Yeah.
I was like, nah, fuck that. We stayed in iTunes.
That's one of my biggest regrets. Like, not putting it on iTunes, because I think it wasn't an original idea, but because the fact that it was just me, and I like, and then I ended up losing the name to MTV2.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, I put it out there, and you know,
we talk about totally off.
Oh yeah, this is a weird tangent, but like, you know, I thought I didn't have a big listenership because I wasn't on iTunes.
Nah,
and
I was. It was like the reason why I stayed on iTunes is because the people that I liked was on iTunes.
Yeah.
Like fucking Cypher Sounds and Rosenberg.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking Combat Jack.
Yeah.
You know, even the idea to this podcast came from like shows like what's the black comic book show shit? It was on loudspeakers with Combat Jack.
Oh, okay.
Then they just talked about comic books and shit like that. And I thought that shit was dope. But it was just like black people talking about comic books.
Yeah.
I thought that shit was fire.
Yeah, yeah.
Forgot what the fuck the name is.
Like, I remember, like, I got into it, like, right around you, when you did, and I was listening to, like, Legion of Skanks, and I was listening to, like, those guys, and it was, like, real.
But this is even before Legion of Skanks came around, bro.
Because they've only been around, really, like, 6 years. And
Legion of Skanks only been around, like, a baby, bro.
Yeah.
I'm talking about, like, before. It was, back in the space, it was me, Combat Jack, Juan Epstein.
Yeah.
That was it. Yeah. Then there was another dude who popped up from Canada who was doing, like, hip-hop interviews through the phone and shit like that.
Yeah.
Then it was The Read came out, blew this shit the fuck up, bro.
You know what? Bodega Boys too.
Nah. But it wasn't like The Read, bro. Because The Read got everybody. Yeah. I don't know how they did it. I don't know why. Who was really fucking with them like that? But it turned up. It turned everybody's head. Like, what's the podcast?
Yeah, yeah. I was really late.
I saw that.
I was late.
Did that. And then Tax Stone
was
the hood.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody in the hood was like, yo, the pack top podcast shit.
Yeah.
So then, like, I saw that. That's how I saw it. But I was already out by then.
Yeah.
And then Flip brought me back.
Yeah.
But I was already out. I was like, man, because my people wasn't connecting, and we were trying to do a blog, and like black and blogging days.
Yeah.
We were trying to do the podcast.
Yeah.
So we were doing a podcast and blog. And niggas didn't really understand the podcast shit.
Like a lot,
but it was a podcast for a blog.
You think there's too many now? I think there's too many
podcasts.
Yeah,
but
comedians.
They're not.
I think there's too many.
But they're not going to transition. It's not going to transition. Like Kevin Hart was talking about, he got a radio show and shit like that. Mm. So it's not really gonna. It depends.
You know what it is too, is like, you know, especially me coming from a radio background. It's like there were a lot of people that didn't think podcasts were gonna last. People thought that
Stern.
Yeah, Stern. Yeah, Stern was a big guy. He was like,
now he's about to do podcasts on a book tour.
Yeah, like a lot of the people. It's funny that, you know, a lot of the people that said that podcasts weren't gonna last, like, just they're the ones who stayed in radio and they're transitioning now. Yeah. Like a lot of those people though, they have the clout to do so, and people are gonna listen to them and no matter what. Like, I came up in sports radio, and a lot of those people like started doing podcasts, and those same people told me that podcasts weren't gonna last, and I was like, radio's dead.
Yeah, like
unfortunately, radio's dead.
Anybody who said a podcast is not gonna last doesn't listen to podcasts.
Right,
that's just what it was.
And I give Bill Simmons credit. Bill Simmons, you know, doing sports, like he was the one. He was one of the first sports guys to do it.
I seen the shit. Yeah. I seen it. And then when The Read came out, I was like, it's over.
Yeah.
Like, right when they came out, I was like, it's over. These motherfuckers, everybody's going to start doing this shit.
By the way, my audition date at Comic Strip Live, July 21st, 2020. What? That's how long I have to wait. Because there were that many people there, by the way.
That sounds crazy. Yeah.
I don't even, like, I know I'm going to be doing stand-up by then, but, like, what if I'm not, you know? Like, who cares? What if?
Commit. Because I'm telling you, you've been committed for this long. Just keep going.
No, yeah, I'm not going to stop. Because
it's so many people doing it.
Yeah.
But it's like, you know before, and now you know after.
Yeah.
Like you know when, when you were doing stand-up in front of like six people, bro.
Yeah, I'm still doing stand-up in front of six people.
Like,
I'm still doing stand-up in front of six people, but.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm
funnier now,
I've seen it. Like, you have to buy your own drink to get in the club and do the shit. Like, I've seen the shit.
No, I have. I will say I have come a long way, and like, and there's a long way to go still. But like that's why listening to I'm looking forward to listening to the Kevin Hart episode of Joe Rogan. But the Schultz one, yeah. Andrew Schultz was the reason I've been putting clips of mine on Instagram. Like
on
that.
Instagram, yeah, no, definitely.
And
use
like,
that shit.
Like who you know? I'll go to a show. I'll do a show, and I'll do five minutes, 10 minutes, whatever. And I'll record it, and like it just sits there.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, as soon as he started talking about that, I was like, you know what? Fuck it, I'll do it too. The next step is to figure out how to add text to the video, and then you know do it that way.
I'll show you that.
Yeah.
Yeah. The next thing I think for you
can
is
I do that in iMovie?
Figure out. Yeah, you can. Right. The next thing I'll figure out is the audio quality, bro.
Yeah.
Try to get if you know like the person who has the board.
Yeah.
Get like one of those. Recorded things,
yeah, yeah,
and just tell them, yo, put the output to my recorder.
Couldn't I just put the like I have a task cam. Couldn't I just put the task cam like next to me or
yeah? But
know.
You want the sound from the mic, bro.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So get the person there. Just be like, yo, hook up my recorder real quick. Hit record. Have it ready.
Yeah.
So this way, he just plugs it out to your end.
Yeah.
Hit record, and then go upstairs.
And at that point, it's just a matter of, we can talk about this after. But
yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
But all right, so the Kevin Hart special, I thought was good. I watched the Amy Schumer one too. Did you see that one? The new
no,
one?
Amy Schumer got one.
Yeah,
I'm gonna watch it.
It's all right.
I'm gonna watch it.
She's, I don't know, like.
But yeah, I watched the Kevin Hart shit again.
Yeah, I would. Yeah, I would.
It's short.
It's not. Yeah, it was like an hour. It's not that long.
It's cool.
I just
it's
find
not better
it
than
so,
Chappelle shit though.
No,
Chappelle
of course not.
Shit. Fuck
it. I find it baffling. I just. Like not just that it's an arena, but you're surrounded all 360. Like that's just.
But that's the idea. Like I figure, like when I like go to a comedy show in an arena, yeah. I would think it would look like that.
Yeah. Like
and shout out to you too, because they're the ones who made that.
Yeah.
That shit up.
Like, isn't it crazy to go to an arena? Like, let's. I'm like thinking about like
Drake
going to Madison
like
Square
that,
Garden, and like sitting up in like the top level seats and watching a stand-up comedian is just mind boggling to me. And like I just think about it from my perspective as a comic, like what's that like to do? You know, like how is that, like what's that feeling to? Because like I'm used to.
I remember Joe Rogan saying something like, "It's hard to gauge like everybody."
Yeah.
So you just do your shit. But
yeah, that makes sense.
He says it's like a longer pause. Like when you watch a special, mm-hmm. you really not watch. Like I've never been to a comedy show like that. But when you watch
a special?
Yeah.
Like yeah, I've been to a couple in like a regular.
But they're saying like in an arena, the comedian kind of pauses a little longer because you have to wait for the room to come back.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Because like by the time people, like in the farther away seats.
Yeah, because when you're watching a special on TV, it's like joke after mm-hmm. joke.
Well, it's edited. Yeah, it's
yeah,
edited well.
But when you're there, they say like, I guess he pauses a little longer after
yeah.
the laughs.
Yeah.
So.
You know what was funny? Like the part where I forgot which joke it was, but there was a guy sitting up front, and he was like, "Did you get?" No, it was the one where he's talking about the when he went to Japan.
Yeah, yeah.
And like the
so excited,
yo, so excited.
Yo, that shit is funny, man.
When he was
that
like,
shit is funny to me. I don't know why. That, like people, if you don't laugh at certain shit.
You're just not
yeah, like
you're not a happy person, really.
Yeah, you just I don't know why that shit is funny to me.
When he said like what's your room number, he's like it's on the phone, and he's like line house. He's like
yeah.
And then he turned to the guy in the audience. He's like, did you get it?
That wasn't that funny, but the
I thought it was
so
great,
excited
it was,
shit is funny, man.
I thought it was great because it was like a real moment for a second, and he was like, I feel like you should have given me more of a laugh on that one because I feel that. I was like, sometimes I'll see somebody like, you didn't laugh as hard as you should have. I don't know. you need to give me more. Like I felt that. I thought it was really good.
Yeah. I got it, but it was like, all right, bro.
It wasn't the joke the that was funny. Was it was so the reaction.
Excited, man. Yeah. That shit is funny.
When he said it was just a shuttle to get to the to the real.
He thought it was the fucking roller coaster. So like that shit is funny, man. I don't know. If you don't find certain shit funny, like his animations and shit,
yeah.
I don't know. Like, you know, you just don't like comedy, bro.
I think people, especially when you get to a level like Kevin Hart, people, it's easy to hate on him.
They put high expectations.
Not even that. I think it's easy to be the one to be like, oh nah, he's not funny anymore. He's lost it. It's easy to do that because you.
But he's doing the same shit he's been doing.
Yeah,
and it works.
Yeah,
like I'm sorry, I hate to say it to people, but the shit works.
Yeah,
if it don't work for you, that's cool. But that shit works.
Like, you know,
because it's relatable. It's you know, like, it's not like you can't.
A guy like Cat
understand
Williams.
Him talking about his kid. Like, right. What else you want him to talk about? They want him to talk about politics.
Nah,
you know, some like, people just you don't need to.
I don't do any political humor because I don't care enough to do the research to write a joke. To I don't care. It doesn't affect me day to day. Like I'm gonna like me. I talk the same thing with any good comedian's gonna talk about them. Their day to day.
I think day to day shit is funny.
Yeah, because like it's you funny. Said, it's relatable. Like.
I like Kevin Hart, like, same way I like Pete Holmes shit.
Yeah.
Not a lot of people like that shit. I like that shit. Because they talking about shit.
Did you like Crashing?
That we can all go through. I love Crashing. But they talk about shit.
I had mixed feelings about it.
Yeah, all right, whatever. But they talk about shit that we all kind of go through and think about. You know what I'm saying? Like, you think about death. You think about Chinese people, crazy shit.
To me, the best comedy is something, like, the best comedy, the best jokes to me are the ones where you're like, oh, when I see a comic say something that's really good, I'm like, damn, I could have thought of that, but I didn't. And like the fact that it's something that happens every day, and I'm not the one that came up with it, tells me that's a well-written joke. That's a good joke.
Yeah, facts.
Like the jokes I do about diabetes, not a lot of people have diabetes, but when I explain it, and people just realizing, Doug, when he was talking about his daughter getting her period, and he said blood butt, I fucking lost it. He's great.
He's very funny, man.
And then people don't realize, doing an hour every year is not easy.
Nah, he said every 2 years.
Yeah.
Every 2 years.
It's hard. I've been doing this shit 9 years. I don't have an hour.
Right?
I don't think I have an hour. I might have an hour, bro. I have an hour, maybe 20 minutes of it.
But you know why? You know why you don't have an hour? It's because now so many people are doing comedy that they kick you off the stage, bro.
Yeah. That's why I like when Netflix
did
that.
It's no time. Like, these high-level comedians, they got time to work on their shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because they got the respect, and then they go into clubs where they're respected.
Yeah.
And only those guys are respected. So they could stay up there for an extra 5 minutes. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
With you, it's like, you go to these clubs, it's like, all right, next person. You know what I'm saying? They're ready to,
That's why I like what Netflix did with hard out. The 15 minute special. It was like there was like 8 comedians doing 15 minutes. I think it's perfect. The other thing is too for me is like I think that we there's a lot of pressure to have an hour to back in the day.
Yeah.
Like let's say I started.
But I think you should go on the road, bro.
I would love to go on the road.
That's what you're on the road.
If that's how my career ends up being a road dog, I'm down for it.
I don't think that's
it's
how
miserable
it would end up
sometimes, but
I think that's how it would end up. But I think you, because you've been doing it so long here, that you would find way more value on the road. Like I know you've done Jersey, maybe.
I've done Jersey, Philly.
I'm talking go to Florida.
Yeah.
One time.
Well, you know, it's funny. I've been signing up for a bunch of I've been submitting for a bunch of festivals all over. There's one in North Carolina that I submitted for. There's one in Rhode Island I really want to do. So they're all coming up and I've been submitting. So if I can do those, it's more of an opportunity to kind of, like you said, hit the road and try other venues and try other spots.
Yeah, even if it's a day, bro, just go out there, do your shit and bounce.
Like, you know, take the Chinese bus over to D.C. I have a lot of, I know a few people in D.C. that could probably put me up. I could probably try that, but, you know, we'll see. But the thing is, you look at comics in the 80s, if all you needed was 10 minutes. maybe.
Yeah, but even them, they would go on the road, bro.
And there was no social media. Like, you could do your same, 10 minutes, and then you get, like, some NBC executive sees you, and you kill him because that's your best 10 minutes. And then next thing you know, you got an NBC deal for 20, 50 grand, and then you get a sitcom, and that's how all these guys got shows. Now, everybody sees everybody. Everybody
gotta be on the internet. Yeah. Which brings us to our next.
Right. You know,
go ahead, finish your thought. Finish it.
But nah, now everybody's on social media. Everybody's online, and everybody's got their clips online.
Yeah,
and you can't do those same jokes over and over again. So there's more pressure to write and keep writing.
Yeah,
which I think is good, because the good writers are gonna rise to the top. Like the shitty ones, you know, you can tell who doesn't
really
respect
write their shit.
Yeah, who doesn't respect the craft and write more.
That's what I'm saying. If there's 300 people going to an open mic, that shit is weeding out. Like,
and I'm, you know, and
a lot of people are not there for some bullshit reason.
Not to shit on anybody, but like, there's a lot of people out there that are famous for comedy that don't write, that aren't funny. And I'll tell you off air who I think those people are, because like, those are the same people that will show up to a booked show that you book them on, and like, they get high and they can't do 5 minutes, if you know they said they would do 10. Or there's people that, you know, they show up and or they bail. I hate, you know what I hate the most of anything in comedy? The one thing I hate the most is if you have a legitimate excuse why you can't make a show, fine. But like, people that don't show up and don't say anything, I hate that. I would never, wherever I'm booked, I always show up. Like, no matter what, I show up early.
Yeah.
Like whatever. I respect the craft that much. There are people that like just won't show up, and I fucking can't stand it.
That's kind of crazy. I mean, you don't know what's going on there. Like,
no, yeah, yeah.
Drug addicts or whatever.
But if you bail twice on me, I'm sorry. I'm not booking you no more.
Yeah.
All right. So the internet, right? We were talking about.
So everybody's shit is on the internet and all that. So this brings us. You want to do a series?
Let's do searching.
Did you watch all of them?
What do you mean?
All the movies.
Yeah.
You did?
You watched
one and two?
No, I didn't watch the first one. You told me not to.
I didn't tell you not to. I just said you don't have to.
Oh, no, I just watched Game Night.
You watched Game Night.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're talking about...
Unfriended.
Unfriended, which we'll talk about. I'll talk about the first one.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll talk about Unfriended, Unfriended
and,
2.
And Searching.
And Searching.
Yeah.
Searching is the latest one.
Let's wait on Searching.
Okay.
Or do you want to do that first?
And No. Unfriended is the first one.
Okay, so yeah, go through that, because I don't know
if it's the same director.
Okay.
I don't think so.
I haven't looked that up.
But I don't know if it's the same director as these movies.
Yeah.
Like, if all of them have the same director. Mm. But the concept is dope as fuck.
Oh, yeah. I feel like, I didn't look up the budget or anything, but I feel like they spent...
Cost nothing to me.
Right? Very little.
I can make that fuck.
Yeah. It was so good.
Good, right?
Yeah.
So, it's like...
So, explain Unfriended, because I didn't see Unfriended 1.
Okay, Unfriended is kind of like Unfriended 2. But it's like, it's a guy and his friends, they're all on Ustream chat. What was it, Ustream chat? No, Google chat.
Yeah.
Right? They're all on Google chat. And it was a friend died. One of their friends died.
Okay.
And they took a picture of this friend. Like, well, not her, like her last moments were recorded.
Okay.
I think she killed herself.
Oh, shit.
For bullying.
Oh, she was bullied?
Yeah, in a way, yeah. So it's like they were at a party and it was embarrassing. They put up like this picture and they, and like, it was a whole thing. And then she killed herself. And then basically Unfriended is like, she comes back from the dead through the internet and kills these people on the day on her birthday.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Right?
Was she really dead? Or was she really...
Well, it comes up on the screen like somebody's watching, which Unfriended 2 kind of explains.
Mm.
You understand? So it comes up on the screen. Somebody's in the chat with them. They can't get them out. Like, who the fuck is that? Who's in the chat? Who's that? So then, like, one person starts dying. Like, one person...
One by one?
Yeah. One person, like, gets their hand stuffed in a blender. And, like... crazy. Yeah, this happens in Unfriended 1. Unfriended 1 is kind of cheesy.
Okay.
Not gonna lie.
Okay.
It's kind of cheesy, but it's suspenseful, but it's if you've never seen it before, it's suspenseful, but
all right.
That's kind of the premise. Like, is a girl, she died, and now she's coming back through the internet to wreak havoc.
Okay.
Unfriended 2.
Right, so the main guy in Unfriended 2,
yeah,
he finds a laptop.
Yes.
And because his laptop is shit, and he finds a laptop so that he has a better quality camera so he could talk to his deaf girlfriend.
Which is awesome.
Yeah.
Unfriended 2 is way deeper than Unfriended 1.
So he creates this app that allows him to communicate sign language to his girlfriend.
Yeah.
Which she made a good point. She was like,
she made an app for the shit.
He did, yeah.
Yeah.
So, and her, she was mad at him because she was like, this is helping you talk to me. It's not helping you understand what I'm saying. You know what I mean? Yeah, it felt like he was like, she's right. He was being too lazy to learn sign language.
Learn shit.
Rather than learn it, he'd rather make an app so that he could talk to her.
Yeah.
And so, and then she would type, which I understand why she was so upset. Anyway, so he finds his laptop.
But he could type too.
Right. I don't know why he had to create an app. Well, yeah, I don't know.
It's
why
a stupid app.
Yeah.
It's a
papaya?
Dumb
papaya? Why was it called papaya? It was a dumb name.
I guess she likes papayas. I don't know.
They didn't explain that, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, so he finds his laptop and like he's talking to it. It's game night. They're all playing Cards Against Humanity.
Yeah.
Which I don't understand how they did it. How do you play Cards Against Humanity?
On the internet?
Yeah. You kind of have to be there, don't you? Like someone has to.
I don't remember that, but I haven't seen it in a while.
Unless they all have like.
I just wanted to review it because I seen searching and I'm like, oh, he should watch this.
Yeah, yeah.
If we watch
this. So, they're playing Cards Against Humanity, and the laptop that he found belonged to somebody else, and he starts getting like Facebook messages from somebody. And he's like you're a thief. And I watched it on my laptop, and the quality wasn't great. So like some of the things I couldn't read the messages.
Yeah, that's a movie you gotta watch. Like you can watch it on the laptop.
Though. Yeah, yeah, but the quality, the version I had, it was a little blurry.
Okay.
So it was a little hard to read some of the messages, but I got the gist. So basically, the owner of the laptop was like, "Yo, you're a thief! Give me my fucking laptop!" And then he's like, "If you don't give me my laptop, I'm killing everybody."
Yeah, yeah.
Basically. So.
That's after the dark web shit.
Right. Oh, right. Yeah. Because what was it? It was like.
It's the dark web.
He stumbled across. Yeah. He stumbled across videos of like. Basically.
People getting stuffed in fucking containers.
Yeah. People getting killed. Being chained, yeah.
And shit.
So
like that.
Basically, there's like this like secret society. That
on the dark web. No, it's not a secret society. It's a dark web contract killing thing.
Right.
So people put out contracts on you and can kill you.
Right.
Based on dark web.
Yeah. So they're just like, it's like a live stream and people are watching and like there's a, so he's got a folder.
It's like Black Mirror episode with, the bees.
Yeah. 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 So it's all live stream and there's like a folder of videos. It's called contributions, and it's like people that are actually doing the killing and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So he doesn't tell his friends, which I thought was kind of weird. Like I would have freaked out and be like, "Yo, something weird's going on."
No, he said that, but he didn't show them.
Like way after he said it was a game at first. He was like, "Oh, it's a game."
Because he didn't think it was real.
Right.
He thought it was some bullshit just on the laptop.
And then, the owner of the laptop is like, "Yo, if you call the cops or if you tell your friends, I'm killing your girlfriend and I'm killing your friends one by one." Yeah. I thought the dopest one.
So basically, that dude, I believe, I don't know if it's separate or whatever, but that contract killing shit is like Unfriended. The first one. Like how those people died is kind of the same way.
Okay.
Like they don't know what's going on. Somebody comes in the house, you can't really see who it is. Like, that's what it is.
Right.
So, I think Unfriended 2 explains how that happened.
Gotcha. Okay. That makes sense.
People were just dying on the internet, and you don't know.
Kind of like Final Destination, you felt like.
Yeah, yeah. You think it's this fucking dead girl.
Yeah.
But
it was actually a contract killer.
I think Unfriended 2 shows that it's actually contract killing.
Like, people doing shit. The best one to me was the one where they pieced together the guy's words and they call the cops and said he's got like guns and shit like that.
Yeah, yeah.
And then the cops came, busted in the house and fucking shot him up. I thought it was crazy. I thought it was dope.
That's unbelievable, bro.
Yeah. And then you know what that was crazy? When they photoshopped the main guy's face into the video with where you see like the guy like pulling his hoodie up.
Yeah.
I thought that was a crazy one too, because I was like, oh shit, they're gonna frame this guy, like the whole thing. And then they made it look like the British guy killed himself.
Yeah. That shit is real, though. Yeah. Like, people could really... That movie shows you that you could really get fucked up in
yeah,
internet,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Like, the internet can really fuck you up if like, they want you to, if they want to fuck you up.
Like, when you, yeah,
it's
exactly.
not the government. It's not, like, yeah. this is how I thought. Like, it's not a government conspiracy.
No.
It's not none of this shit. These are regular fucking people who can hack into, regular hackers.
Yeah.
Who can hack into your shit and get you fucking killed.
Yeah. Just for fun.
For fun.
Like the.
For a fucking, for like a fucking $1 million contract. Yeah.
Yeah.
Get, kill this dude. I dare you.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, oh,
did
shit.
Did you ever seen Nerve? You ever seen that movie Nerve?
No.
It's sort of similar. It's like this truth or dare live action game where like you get, you, I think you get points or money or whatever for doing things. And like, you know, it's like meet this guy, you know, kiss him, kiss this random dude. It's like, it,
nah.
check that out. It's sort of in the same
it's like
vein
phone
a little
booth.
Bit. Yeah. It's sort of like Phone Booth. Yeah. check out Nerve.
This movie is like Phone Booth.
Yeah.
In
yeah.
a way.
Check
You're
out Nerve.
You're stuck
if you get
in
a
one
chance.
Spot.
Yeah, exactly. But not with in Nerve, they're moving around. They're doing, it's like oh, it's yeah. John Franco's little brother and like the girl.
Never saw that.
It's yeah, check it out. But anyway, they fucking go through this shit and like they're all dying one by one and like the when they fucking they kill the chick's mom
yeah.
in the hospital and they make her choose.
Yeah, choose.
Son, that shit was crazy.
Some crazy
she
shit.
She should have chosen. Who would you have chosen?
Who would you choose
between
the
girlfriend's mother in the hospital or the girlfriend? I would have chosen the girlfriend.
Nah, the mother gotta go, bro.
That's what I'm saying.
She already
she's gonna she's in the hospital. She's gonna die anyway. All right, I choose. I think no matter what, if you had chosen, she would
still fucked up either
yeah.
way.
Yeah, it was a good movie. I would. I don't think I'll watch it again because I've, you know, seen it. But
yeah, once you see it, it's a one and done.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a one and done movie, but it's
but good. I would definitely recommend it.
If you've never seen it,
definitely watch it.
Well, if you've never seen it, we just spoiled the whole movie, so fuck
it. But watch it anyway.
It's a good movie to see. It's yeah. a good way to see how the internet could, somebody on the internet could actually kill you if they wanted
yeah.
to. It's ways that you probably wouldn't have thought of.
It's funny because I watched it on my laptop and like it's the perspective was crazy because I have a MacBook and like.
But that's why they make the movie like
yeah.
that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because they know you're going to watch it yeah. on your fucking computer.
Yeah.
So you're watching on your computer as somebody's,
as
on,
somebody's
computer,
on the computer.
And you're like, fuck.
Yeah. I was like, All right. For a, like, I had to walk away. For, I had to pause it and walk away just to make sure that what. Because like
not
some,
on your computer?
Yeah. Because every so often something would pop up and I'm like, no, that's not me. Okay. Like I had an email come in at one point and I was like, okay. It's not, that's me.
It fucked you up.
Yo, it did.
Yo, that's funny. I didn't watch this. I watched this movie on the TV,
because I was there was a couple moments where I was just like, same thing with searching. Because I was like, there's a few things. I was like, is that me or is that the movie? Is that mine or is that the movie? I was like, all right, it's probably the movie.
Yo, that's funny.
Yeah,
that's funny. The experience of watching it on a laptop, I didn't think about.
Yeah, it's very.
Watching honestly, that movie on a laptop is crazy.
Watching it on a laptop, I think it adds to the experience.
It probably does.
Yeah,
that's probably why they made the movie yeah. like that. Which is dope.
Searching, it was a little different because not all of it took place on a MacBook, and
it's placed on phones.
Some of it on phones and some of it on a PC. So I was just like,
yeah,
okay,
yeah, yeah.
Like in the very beginning when they showed like the Windows like 98 or Windows 2000 background, I was like,
yeah.
Well, this is clearly, you know, not me. But like at one point, he so basically searching
when he goes on her laptop.
Yeah, when he goes on her laptop, she had a MacBook. I was like, okay, is this me? Okay. So searching basically is about it's I loved it, by the
you
way.
You like searching?
I thought it was great. I'm definitely going to watch it again, by the way.
Yeah. I saw it twice already.
Like so basically it's all through the perspective of a laptop. It's this guy, it's his family, and you see throughout the years of updating videos and updating
yeah, yeah.
pictures that the mom dies of cancer, and basically it's the dad and the daughter. So the daughter's she's in high school,
yeah,
and she goes missing.
Yo, that shit is crazy. That movie is bugged.
Yo,
the fuck
it's
out, bro.
Crazy. Like it went from
it's like Law and Order through a laptop, bro.
Yo,
this shit is fucking crazy.
Yo, and it, like in a way, it's sort of like. A little far-fetched, but I was like, this, I could see this.
It's
sort
not
of,
far-fetched.
How a little bit. A little bit.
How?
Like, why?
How is it, all that shit is possible.
Sure, it's possible, but like, why was the cop trying, like, why was she trying to?
She's not a cop, bro.
Yeah, she was. She was
a fucking volunteer.
I thought she volunteered for.
She's not a cop, though.
She was a detective. Was a cop? Yeah, she was a detective. She volunteered. She wasn't assigned the case.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
She wasn't assigned the case.
Yeah, sorry. But she was retired, though, right? Or some shit like that?
Oh, I don't know. I don't remember that.
I know she wasn't active. She wasn't an active detective.
She wasn't?
No, she came out and said...
I know she chose the case.
So yeah, for a reason.
Well, yeah. So the guy's daughter goes missing, yeah. And he's trying to find her. This lady who I guess is not a detective or whatever.
Well, she's a detective.
She's
at
a detective,
the time.
But and she assigns herself to the case. So they're going through all of this girl's like missed calls, emails, like her Facebook.
The and dad then, is going.
The daughter is. The dad is. Yeah, and he realizes that she has no friends, and he finds her UCast account. Basically, it's like this like. It's like the streaming.
Yeah, it's like all your fucking. It's like IG lives.
Yeah,
like
basically, like you're casting
all
to,
together
to
and like saved where it stores and.
Yeah, it's kind of like a Periscope
webcam.
A little bit.
It's a webcam thing.
Yeah, so he finds out that this is where it started to get a little. This is where it veered and got real bugged out when he finds out that the daughter and his brother. Were like yeah. Chilling.
That shit blew me. I was like, oh, did the fucking brother?
Yeah, do this shit? I was like, yo, they fucking?
Like, did the brother do this shit? This shit is crazy.
Yeah,
I was like, this is out of control. If the brother, I was like, I can't watch this shit.
So no it more. Turns out the brother and the daughter were just the uncle and the daughter. I guess you could call them. Or just smoking weed together
yeah,
because
he was
depressed.
Just selling her weed and shit.
Because she's depressed, and he gets mad at the dad because like, how could you not know that your daughter's depressed and all this other shit? So now, the dad was giving the daughter $100 every week for piano lessons, and she quit piano and saving all that money. And she meets someone who's commenting on her UCast shit. Basically, she got catfished.
Yeah,
she got catfished by the detective's son.
Well, it wasn't a catfish.
Yeah. She didn't really exist.
He wanted to come clean, but he was scared.
He was scared, yeah. And the mom was like, nah, fuck that, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So then the son goes to meet the daughter. The son of the detective goes to meet the daughter.
You gotta just watch it.
You gotta watch it, honestly.
It's mad confusing, but it's...
So basically they go to meet and no, she goes there to do something else. He's like, he feels guilty, so he goes to like tell her, yo, this is all bullshit, blah blah blah.
Yeah.
And it accidentally pushes her off a cliff.
Off the cliff.
And then the mom throws the car into the river.
This is a whole bunch of crazy shit.
And they're like, there's no way she lived, and turns out she was alive though. Look, watch Searching. I'm going to watch it again.
Yeah.
It's very good. It's. I don't know, like I think John Cho got nominated for something.
For that movie?
I think he got nominated for like best supporting or best
good.
Actor. I don't know.
Is it good?
I liked it a lot.
Yeah.
It's good, but
it's not
only
that good.
But like the budget for that couldn't have been that much.
Budget for that is nothing, bro. These movies cost nothing to make.
So good.
Movies cost like nothing to make. It costs a laptop and some fucking actors.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah. Like the scene, like any of the scenes outside of like the scene where he's at work, just fucking get an office. Like just sit in an office for an hour.
Yeah.
You know, the scenes outside, like.
You don't have to do nothing. It
doesn't
do anything. It costs nothing.
You got a phone?
But a laptop.
You got a phone and a laptop?
A phone.
And actors.
And the fucking actors.
Yeah.
It don't cost shit.
I thought it was great. Yeah, I don't think we spoiled it too much. I think we could.
What?
We
spoiled it, man. That's the movie's.
That's the point of the podcast.
The detective
though.
Is a fraud. That spoils the whole movie, honestly.
Yo, the part where he realizes that she has no friends, I was like, oh shit. That's fucked
up.
Nah,
I knew that.
When the one picture that somebody put.
I knew the dude was a catfish too.
Did you?
I just didn't know who it was.
Oh yeah, the fish and chips thing. Yeah, I was like, this is bullshit.
I was like, fish and chips is a stalker.
Yeah.
I got that, because I got people who stalk me. Had a dude run up on me the other day, son.
What?
For Ebok.
What are you talking about?
Looking for his t-shirts.
What? They come up to you looking for Ebok?
Shout out. Yeah.
Did that get resolved?
It would be resolved. Shout out to Percival.
What did they say? Were they upset?
Shout out to Percival. I know you probably watched this, so shout out to Percival.
Was it him?
Huh?
That's who it was?
Dude, Percival, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Shout out to him, man.
Yeah.
Nigga, the way he did it was crazy, though. I was like, I'm walking. He's like, yo, can I speak to you for a second? I thought he was a homeless dude. Because he comes after like, asking me, you know, can we volunteer? He's like, yo, can I speak to you for a second? I was like, yeah, sure.
What?
Right? Yeah, I don't give a fuck. So he came around. He's like, where my t-shirt at, man? I was like, the fuck? I was like, I'm $100. He's like, I'm $100. He's a $100 Patreon subscriber. So I was like, oh, okay, yeah. Nah. I felt bad because I was like, yo, these niggas gotta get their shirts.
Yeah.
So I called Ebok right there.
Okay.
And try to get this shit situated.
That's a weird, like, I'll be honest with you.
We're gonna invite him here just to get his shit, so.
If someone came up to me and said, yo, can I speak to you for a second? I would run so far away.
Why?
Like, who are, I don't know you. Why?
I trust people, man. If you shoot me, you shoot me. Fuck it. Lee's gonna shoot. Shoot me right there. Fuck it.
I don't wanna get shot.
I don't either. But I'm not gonna run away. Like, what? Ah, somebody wants to speak to me. I'm not scared of people.
I'd probably be like, about what?
That's what I was like. I was like, what is this for? But you would never know if the person doesn't come up to you.
Yeah. Like, you know what I get? I used to get caught with, like, the people that they try to get you to sign up for, like, ASPCA. They're like, hey, can I stop?
That's
you
what I thought. I thought it was
right.
Like,
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
Somebody came up to me in a train station. Not about none of this shit.
Yeah.
But some girl, she was, oh, that's a nice shirt. I was like, oh, thanks.
Yeah, like, I get, yeah.
And what did she say? She said some shit. It was about something, like, try to join some group or some shit.
Oh, okay.
But the way she came up to me, I'm like, what the fuck? Yeah. Like, she just came out, hey, that's a nice shirt. Where'd you get it? Oh, yeah. I did
by
this. By the way, yeah. We had a I was like, what? What the fuck? Like, this turned into a fucking pitch?
Yeah.
I was like, I thought you was trying to give me some pussy or something. Like, what the fuck going on here?
I remember one time someone recognized me from a show. And it was the first time, actually. It was the only time, really.
Yeah.
Someone was like, hey, man. I think I've seen you before. I was like, what? And they're like, you do stand-up? I was like, yeah. This was like maybe like a year or two ago. And they were like, yo, man, you're really funny. I was like, thanks. And I was
certain
like,
shit, I was like,
that's weird. Like, never happened before. It hasn't happened since.
Nah?
Yeah. I'm actually kind of scared.
Someone wanted to take a picture with me one time.
Really? Did they think you were somebody else?
No, they knew who I was.
Oh.
Did they take a picture of me?
Oh, shit. Do you ever lie?
It was weird. I was like, what? Like, I don't know I was like, you want to take a picture of me for what? Like, I don't think of me, like, you know what I'm saying?
I was in Farmingdale once.
Like, what the fuck, like, is going on? Like, girls. Flip, I understand. Like, maybe people want to take flips with Flip all day.
Yeah.
But, like, me? Like, I'm behind the scenes. I don't give a fuck.
They've probably seen you.
No, they seen me. They say, yo, Space, you want to take a pic? Yeah. Like, take a pic with me, Space? I'm like, oh, hey, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Did you read the comments in the last episode?
Yeah, they want Ebok.
Yeah.
Shout out to Ebok.
He's
Ebok doesn't do the show because he doesn't have time to watch the movies. He doesn't want to watch some of the movies. So that's why he doesn't do the show anymore.
It's kind
of
tough.
We got another co-host we're working on. She's cool, peoples.
Yeah.
So we'll see when she comes in if she's good or not.
What movies are we watching for next week?
Oh, next week. Okay. I wanted to watch the HBO shit.
What HBO shit?
I'm going to watch Shazam. We'll get to Shazam.
Yeah, Shazam was good.
I'm going to watch Shazam. And then I want to do the HBO shit.
It comes on tonight?
Yeah. It's an HBO movie.
All right.
I'm going to find out right now the name.
What else? I was trying to convince my cousin to go see Us, but she didn't want to see it. She doesn't like scary movies.
It's not scary, though.
Yeah. She, no matter how many times I tell her that, she's not going to.
It's not a scary movie, though.
Yeah. Yo, there was mad kids in the theater going to Shazam, and I've got to tell you, not a kids movie.
It's not a kids movie?
Dog.
Is it like Shaq?
Huh?
Is it like the Shaq or something? Is Shaq in it?
No, Shaq is not. Like,
don't tell me about that.
There's a lot of cursing.
In Shazam?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, not a lot, but there's some cursing. Like, there were children, like 6-7-year-old children in the theater before, like, when I went to see Shazam, and I was like, this is not for you.
Damn, I'm gonna get bad service here. I got this 5G shit now. Like, I don't understand what the fuck this is about. Shit just started showing up. Yeah, but it's a movie, it's on HBO. It's coming out tonight. I think it's about, like, it's like black and white relations or some shit like that.
Let's see. I'm gonna look it up. Let me see.
Yeah, what's my phone on? Is acting up with the lookup shit. Can't hardly look up nothing no more. The Wi-Fi is fucked up. Oh, I'm on the GoPro. That's why.
Is it Native Son?
Yeah, Native Son.
Okay.
Native Son. Yes.
All right, I'll watch that.
Yes. So we'll review Native Son, Shazam. You have another one you want to see or not?
Not really. I can't think of anything.
We'll do Native Son, Shazam, and I think is Avengers after that or no?
Next week.
Next.
The week following. After. Yeah. The 26th it comes out.
Yeah. So then it'll be Avengers after that, right?
The week after. You talking about four next week?
No, next week we're doing Shazam and Native.
Yeah,
Son.
And then the week after that we'll do Avengers.
Yeah, and then the week after that is Avengers.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, no, okay. No. The week after that is Avengers. Sunday, no, the Sunday after the next one. So we'll have to figure out another one.
Yeah, because next week we would do. Yeah, next week we do the Native Son and Shazam.
Shazam,
and then the 21st we'll do. We'll figure something out.
We'll figure something
it's
out.
It's the week after that.
We'll figure something out for that.
Yeah.
Might all right. Something.
Like, share, subscribe, all that stuff. You know what to do. Tell your friends, actually. Tell you.
Yeah. If you want us to see a movie, put it in the comments.
Yeah, suggest one. Suggest something. Matter of fact, how about if you guys have a suggestion for a third movie, suggest it. And we'll review it.
Or we'll just take your suggestions this time around and then we'll use it for the next one.
Sure, we can do that. Yeah.
But we're definitely doing an Avengers big deals thing. Avengers.
Like
episode.
Bring
your friends, man.
Yeah.
Bring your that's my shit people, man. If they can, if they want to come.
They don't leave where they are at. Angel works on Sundays now, I think. And then Chris is in Long Island and he doesn't leave Long Island.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah.
We're here. That's it.
Peace.
Nobody's movie review. Peace.